Well, welcome to our evening time to gather together. For some of your guests that are here, my name is Chris Palmer and I'm the pastor of the church. I don't normally dress like this. I have the awesome privilege tonight, and we have the privilege together of being able to participate in something I believe is one of the most key or very important parts of Christendom, and that's the opportunity to baptize people who have professed and believe and trust and know in their heart that Jesus Christ is their Lord and Savior. It was interesting today, I have several of my people that I know, relatives in different churches that I'm connected to, at least three or four of them had baptismal services today. It's like, that's interesting. It's like, great. We're all thinking alike. No, but this is really good. What we're going to do, though, is we're going to set, because this is such an important event, it's very important then that we set an atmosphere where our hearts, all of us in here, our hearts are open and receptive and prepared and receiving of all that God wants to do tonight. Because this isn't just about the people that get baptized. This is about the church. And when we act by faith, God comes with His grace and pours Himself out on us. And it's a good evening. It's a great night to be able to come before God and let God wash us one more time as we watch the ceremony where those who have professed something that has happened on the inside make a public statement about that on the outside, that in the midst of that we all are also changed. We also all remember the awesome privilege and the mercy and the grace of God that came and changed our lives. And if you're here tonight and don't know Jesus, man, what a great night to know Jesus. So we'll see how that goes. Let me just pray, and go ahead, let's stand, and I'll pray, and we're going to enter into worship, and Tom's going to have bring us through the Word tonight, show us some things that, again, tenderize our hearts, open our hearts, open our ears, to allow God to really move in the midst of us. God, we just come tonight, we thank You, God, for who You are. We thank You, Jesus, for Your death, Your life, Your resurrection, what You did on the cross, You did in the grave, and what You're now doing in the heaven at the right hand of the Father. Lord, we thank You for Your sacrifice. We thank You for the grace and the mercy that You poured out upon us. And Lord, tonight, all the way through this service, God, let us understand and know, and let us be moved and transformed by Your power, by the power, the mighty power of the gospel. Have Your way tonight. Be exalted and be glorified in all things. We praise Your holy name. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Isn't he holy?
Holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled with his glory. Holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled with his glory. The earth is filled with his glory.
We're glad to have visitors with us tonight.
And if tonight would be your first time in a Heartland service, we would like to welcome you. We'd like to acknowledge you. So if that's you and you are brave, would you raise your hand and wave at us so we can clap for you? Right over here, our ushers will bring you a packet. We're so glad that you're with us tonight. You've picked a great night to be here. It's gonna be awesome. They're gonna be giving you a packet, and in that packet you'll find a card. If you would fill that card out and then let us know who you are, if there are any needs we could help you fill, and then just put that in the offering basket as it comes around you. Also, if you're joining us online, we'd like to welcome you tonight. And if this is your first time watching us, we would like you to just put your name in the comments section and let us know that you're here for the first time. And if there are any prayer requests or anything we could do to serve you, we would love to do that. So just drop us a line there. I have a few announcements before we continue tonight, but while I'm doing that, let's take a few minutes and prepare for our offering. We'll be taking up our tithes and offerings soon. And if you have the capability and the desire, it's always good to honor God when we have the opportunity for all that He's given us to give something back. So if you have a little bit of change, if there's a child sitting next to you who would want to drop a little bit of change in, now's the time to get ready to do that. Now for announcements. We're having a baptismal service tonight. Yay! It's going to be awesome because we serve an awesome God, and we're very excited about that. This coming week at the high school and elementary HCA, this is a non-academic week. They don't have regular classes. And on Monday, there will be no one here to take care of your children if you send them. The teachers are going to have a special day and an in-service, and so you need to make sure that you have something lined up for your children to do other than come to this building on Monday. Also, this Wednesday, youth group will be here in our service with us. So don't go over to the other building, or again, you won't find anyone there to serve you. So you'll be joining us. We always love it when we have the youth with us on Wednesday night. So we're looking forward to that. Next Saturday, September 2nd, is the Sons of Promise breakfast. That will begin at 8:15 and will be at the Solid Rock Cafe. So if you're involved with Sons of Promise, join them there for a great time of fellowship. And my final announcement is looking ahead a little. On September 9th, we're privileged to offer some training that we've never been able to do before. It's called Stewards of Children. And this is training for child sexual abuse prevention. Mr. Williams has taken training and he'll actually be teaching this for us. And there are three groups of people who really need to think about taking part in this. First, this is a great avenue for parents. If you have children and youth in your home, it's a great opportunity to learn some ways to interact with them, some things to do and watch for as a parent. So you're invited to do that. The next group is if you are presently serving in this house with youth or children, we are asking that you would attend this training. It's going to be something that will get us all on the same page. It will help us move forward into the day that we're coming into with great power. And then if you're someone who feels like you would like to serve in this house in the capacity of working with children and youth, we would love to have you come and take part in this too. So this is going to be a wonderful opportunity for us to get some grounding and move forward in what God is calling us to. So now as the ushers come forward, we're going to pray and we're going to give our tithes and our offering, if you would bow your head and pray with me. God, thank you for allowing us to be in your house again tonight. God, I'm asking that you take the money that is given in this offering and it would be sown into your kingdom and spread your glory over all the earth. God, even the little that we might give would be miraculously sown so that lives are touched, people are changed, and things happen. We love you, Jesus, and we thank you for the opportunity to give. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.
There is Church, tonight we're meeting, we're being a family, but recognize something, and I want you to stay with this as the night continues. Tonight is supposed to be a celebration. Listen, you can get loud, you can get wild tonight. That's okay. Come on. Amen. We got 19 people going to get baptized. Amen. Now understand, there are places in the world this is highly illegal. They'll put you to death for what we're going to do tonight. There are churches in America that would be so desperate to have one person beg to be baptized, cry out to be saved. And many times we can gloss over that. We've got 18, 19, how many more that God's brought to us that want to be saved? You know, we can get wild tonight. It's okay. This is an awesome event. This is something worthy of praise. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Guys, I'm proud of you. I was standing over here, and you have no idea how awesome this is. This is, and listen to me, we don't even touch the cusp of it. In heaven tonight, I promise you, there's a party going on. Amen. Before we pray, I do want to ask a favor of you on a personal note. My grandmother, her name's Vivian. She's 88 years old. This week, she was diagnosed with brain cancer. Listen to me. She's a sweetheart. If any of you could meet her, you'd say, I want to take her home with me, please. Tomorrow morning at 7:20, she goes into surgery. Pray for her. We're going to pray tonight, but if you will, tomorrow morning when you wake up, say a prayer for her. Let's go to the Lord before we begin. Father, we thank you so much, Lord, for the privilege, the honor, God, the blessing of coming to your house. God, to be your bride, to be the body. God, there's times we come to hear a word that is to correct us, to teach us, to grow us. And God, there's times like tonight, we come just to celebrate, to be your church and to embrace you as you are. God, because you meet us where we are. Father, tonight I pray that you would be in our midst. God, that as Pastor said earlier, you would tenderize our hearts. And God, that you touch us. Holy Spirit, that you would have your way in this place. Lord, that you would seal within those tonight, those that are going to be baptized, what it truly means to be yours, to be held in your hand, to identify completely with you. Lord, touch them, seal them. And Lord, show us what that means as a body. What it means to die to the old and now to be found in the new. Lord, I pray you touch my grandma. God, give the doctors wisdom tomorrow. And Lord, give her body strength to handle this surgery. Lord, that it would be a praise report. God, because your people rose up and prayed, you moved. And God, all the more, move tonight. Move in this service, Father, not just on the ones that are being baptized, but on your church as a whole. God, you be lifted high. You be glorified. You, Father, show us what it means to identify completely in you. We love you, God. We thank you. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. You can be seated. I want to take just a little bit before we begin. Like I said, we've got, I believe it's either 18 or 19 people getting baptized tonight. And again, praise God for that. That's a wonderful thing. Yeah, you can clap again, please. But before we begin, I do feel like there's some time we need to spend in God's word before we move forward. You know, baptism is not a light thing. Not in any capacity. And it's been done differently throughout history. You know, Jesus didn't baptize in a tub like that. Jesus didn't get baptized in a tub like that. But it doesn't matter. You see, what matters is the outward expression of an inward deliverance. An inward change. You see, there's a transformation that goes on. And it really is a miracle. It's supernatural. It is the equivalent. Understand this. The salvation experience that you have come into contact with when God opened your eyes. You know, I'm working on a message sometime called the Mystery of Christ. And we have to understand that God is the only one that can open our eyes to our need of him. And when he does that, he does a supernatural work deep down inside and changes us. What we're going to do tonight is we're going to scream to the mountaintop, scream to the world, I'm changed. I identify now no longer with my old life, but with a new life. I'm different. And I want to take some time and just dig into what the Word of God has to say about this. You know, it's interesting. Jesus Christ showed up on the earth, and he lived here for 30 years before he ever entered into ministry. Now understand, Christ himself was a Jew. He followed the Jewish customs to a T. There were things they were off with, and he showed them where they were wrong. But for all practical purposes, Jesus' life identified with that of a common first century Jew. And one of the things that's interesting is Jesus waited until he was 30 to go into ministry because Jewish culture said this: a man had no reputation or authority to teach or preach or lead until they reached that age. There was actually a word that they would use called the miksha, that a man would receive when he reached that age and would be then allowed to speak or teach or to be a rabbi and have disciples. But all the more, when Jesus reached the age of 30, he didn't just rush into ministry. There was an event that takes place. You know, if you, you don't have to turn there right now. But if you look at the book of Mark, Mark doesn't even talk at all about Jesus' upbringing, childhood. He just almost glosses over it and starts with the baptism of Jesus. And it's very interesting. You know, you see in the book of Matthew chapter 3, we almost have the biggest picture of the baptism of Jesus. And this was a very, very, very important event. So much so, the Bible says, when Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist, he comes up out of the water, and the Bible says the heavens parted. And what happened? The Holy Spirit descended upon him like a dove. And the second witness, the Father from heaven, speaks, "This is my Son, in whom I am well pleased." You see, this was no ordinary event. This was no simple task. Oh, I'm dunked and I'm raised and I go on. There really is a significance to this event, because it was this event that opened the door for Christ to step into ministry. Jesus is called directly from this event into ministry. And I want to say that that's not unique to Christ. There really is an open door that God wants to press open. There's a door in your life and in mine. And listen to me, for those of you being baptized tonight, there's a ceiling that God wants to put over you. He wants to open your eyes to understand the identity now that you walk in. That who you are is not who you were. And we're going to see a part of that tonight, because it's not just for those being baptized, but I really believe that God wants to speak to us individually, but as a body, about this identity that we find in baptism. You see, it's interesting. You read one of the Christian classics, Pilgrim's Progress. A man by the name of Christian has a weight on his back. He goes around with this weight, and it just keeps getting bigger and bigger and weighing him down more and more and more until he comes to the cross of Christ and is able to deposit that weight. You see, in the first century, one of the things that was unique about this baptismal experience and why it was so important for Jesus to be baptized was that ordinary Jews could come to the river and begin to confess. Begin to lay down their trespasses, to take them off. You see, how many of us, we walk around, we spend our entire life weighed down by what happened yesterday. Both symbolically yesterday and many, many years ago yesterday. We live that way, and more than that, we identify by those things. And yet, God wants us to understand that baptism is truly a death of an old and a raise to life in the new. Turn with me, if you will, to Romans chapter 6. I want to read it for you. Romans chapter 6, when you get there, look at verse number 3. If you don't have your Bible with you, just look at the Christian sitting next to you. I'm sure they got theirs. Romans chapter 6, looking at verse number 3. Paul says this: "Do you not know that all of us who've been baptized into Christ were baptized into his death?" Now, listen to me. Thank God we didn't have to go through it like he did. Praise God for that. "We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death." Now, get this. "In order that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life." We too might walk in newness of life. How many of y'all would like a blank, fresh start? You ever thought about that before? I know there are people in this room, you've moved to new locations just for that fresh start. You've left a city or a home or a location because the place you lived in before, you by your own lifestyle, had ruined your reputation. You'd been identified with something that wasn't good. And sometimes it had nothing to do with you. You know, I've known of people that because of their family, they were marked. And no matter where they went in that town, they were identified with the deeds of their father or their grandfather, and they couldn't shake it. And they had to get away. They needed a fresh start, a clean slate, some way to start over. And yet right here we find in the scriptures, God says, I've got that for you. I've got that fresh start for you. You can identify no longer with what happened yesterday. And you see, that is so incredibly important for us as believers. Why? Because as human beings, we come into God's house, we come into God's kingdom with the old. And that's all that we've ever known. The things that happened in our life, the patterns that we've developed in our life, they have defined us both for the good and for the bad. And what's interesting about that, now make no mistake about it, God makes us all unique. And that's to his glory. But some of the things that we hold on to that make us unique don't bring glory to God. They don't honor God. There's things that we think are unique about ourselves. Well, that's just the way that I am. Well, if you don't like it, get over it. And we hold on to things that are broken, not right. We cling to them as if they're truly a part of us. And yet we don't understand that God didn't make us that way. And he doesn't intend for us to stay that way. And I want to look at just two areas of this tonight before we move forward. The first is this: in the old life, coming into the kingdom of God, how many of you identified, I was broken, I was wrong, I was weak, I'd failed, I was this, I was that, I was this, I was that. Understand and thank God that many times that the awareness of those things may have brought us to the cross. The awareness of our brokenness, that may bring us to the place where, God, I've got an addiction. God, I've got a broken thing inside of me that I can't fix. But you see, what happens is we live in a culture today that we try and excuse those lifestyles. My wife had a video on earlier today of someone on Facebook talking about how drug addiction really is a disease. You get it like the common cold. I just can't quit. And many people will buy into that. Go to an AA meeting. Go to an NA meeting. Yeah, I'm a recovering this. I'm this. Hi, my name's Tom, and I'm an alcoholic. And we allow things that were never meant to define us to do exactly that. We allow circumstances. I'm the child of a divorced family. I'm the product of an abusive father or an abusive mother. And we allow things that have happened to us to define us. Well, I'm a drug addict. Well, I'm a pervert. Well, I'm a this, or I'm a convicted felon, or I'm a this. And we allow those things to truly identify who we are. And yet God never once intended for us to stay that way. He never desired for you to remain broken, empty, without hope. You know, I said last week, sometimes we've got Christians that they live their life on life support. They don't ever get out of the hospital. They just barely get by. Oh, my prayer life is so weak, and I just fall at every wave of doctrine. No. Why do they fall? Because they don't understand their identity. They don't know what happened. They don't understand the victory that was won. You see, the Bible says that you and I are, get this now, more than conquerors. Amen. Do you understand that? We're more than conquerors. Yes. I like the way Phil Pano described it. He talked about an individual that won the day, won an award, and you come up and snatch it from him. Nope, I'm more than a conqueror. I beat you. Now, in the same way, when we look at what Christ did, he won the day. He snatched the keys of literally death and Hades. And you know what he does? He says, guess what? You don't have to fear anymore. You don't have to walk around being afraid of what you don't understand or can't comprehend, because I own it. And I only bring good things to my children. I'm only going to allow good to come to you. You may not understand it. You may not see it in the moment, but I promise you, in my glory, you're going to see your good. And it may take time sometimes for us to recognize how the broken areas of our lives God can use for good. And God will use for good. But we have to understand the transition that must take place in our lives. What am I saying? Let me be very specific with you. There are things in my life I wrestle with. There are areas in me that I still have to fight battles on. You know what happens when I get weak? Or when I go through a battle, or it's been a month and it's just been difficult? And I see God overcome. I see God win the day. You know what I understand in my life? That's an opportunity now, because that thing doesn't define me anymore, to tell somebody about it. To say, Keith, let me tell you something. Last week was rough, but God brought me out of it. And he says, you know what? I've been there, man. Last month was rough, but God was faithful. And we can sit and talk, and listen to me, we can glory together in our weaknesses. Why? Because I don't identify with that old man, that drug addict, that fool, that moron, all the things I used to be. He's at the bottom of that pool. And I don't care how deep you go, you'll never find it. Because my Bible says God threw it in the sea of forgetfulness. It's over with. And I don't have to identify any longer with who I used to be. You see, I'm free of that, and so are you. When we're hidden in Christ, God's made us new. He's changed us. You can get excited about it. It's okay. You see, a lot of us, we just don't walk in that. Oh, ho-hum. Oh, well, I'm just getting by. No. The victory is yours. You've won. It's yours. You are radically different. You are completely changed. Never to be the same. Never to go back to who you used to be. But Tom, I'm just so weak. I mean, I stumble every day. You're right. That's because the power is not yours. But you've got a fountain that will never, ever, ever run dry. The thing you've got to learn is how to get there. How to go there, how to walk with that fountain constantly with you. You see, there's a reason the Spirit of God comes to dwell on the inside of us. He understands, like the one that wrote the hymn of, bind my heart, Lord, my ever-winding heart, Lord, to you. God understands our weakness. Read the book of Hebrews. He understands our wayward heart, and he says, I'm going to literally live on the inside of you so I can remind you. So I can use my word to tell you, you're different. You're a new creation. You're not the same. You identify as new. And when we begin to walk in that, in the entirety of that, knowing every day you wake up, whether you're sick, whether you're hurt, whether you're weak, I don't have to be who I was yesterday. God's made me different. And you see, understand, that's one of the number one areas the enemy's going to come at you. Just like he did Jesus. Jesus literally leaves being baptized, goes right into the wilderness, and the devil says, you know, if you really are the Son of God, you know, if you really are Jesus, prove it. You see, he instantly tries to tear down at that identity. He instantly wants us to make us doubt the work that God's done. Why? Because it's supernatural. We can't see it, but we live it. We can't describe it, but we can't deny it. And the more that you live it, the more that you walk in it the way that God told us to, the more you're going to grow in it, and the more it's going to grow on you. I'll get back to that in a moment, but I want to quickly discuss the second point and why baptism is so important in our culture. For this reason, we live in a culture, we live in a time where individuals want to define what sin is, what wrong is. They want to tell us if we disagree with them, we're bigots, we're Nazis, We're evil. We're bad people. And you see, that's a very easy argument for the Christian to win. It's not about us. It's not about us defending what we stand on. I don't have to prove to anybody the integrity of the Bible. All I got to say is, hey, he said it, not me. Hey, this came from a lot higher boss than me. God said this, so I'm going to do it. And I'm not going to apologize for what he said. And you see, we live in a culture today that says, well, I can do this or live this way and still be a Christian, and everybody should be fine with it. And the issue is God says, I'm not fine with it. I'm not okay with it. And they say, well, you're a bigot. You're wrong. You're evil. The thing we have to realize is this. We are not the ones that define what God says. Scott sent an email last week, and in it he said, God did not call us to be editors of his word, but to simply be newsboys. We don't edit God's word. I don't change it to suit what I believe. It's my job just to spread the word, just to tell everybody, hey, did you know? Here's the news. I'm to report on what God has said. And how that happens practically in your life and in mine, we see in this tub. Listen to me, man. Let me be very clear with you. What happens tonight is this. There are still in your life, there are still in your body desires that don't honor God. There are things that you know I got to wrestle against. You put them to death in this tub. You see, we take captive. Just like Pastor was saying this morning, the mind is changed. How? In submission to God. And what we do is in baptism, we say, I no longer want to identify with my lust, my desire, my brokenness. I allow that to be crucified. I allow that to be put to death. And then, as I'm submerged, I'm raised to new life. You say, I struggle with this. Then put it to death. I'm weak in this area. God understands. You know, let me say this really, really quickly. I know for a fact there, and this is a hot button topic. I know for a fact there are those in this room that wrestle with something like homosexuality. And they want to hide it and put it in the closet and be ashamed of it. God understands right where you are. And no matter if it's that or any other thing that God calls us to lay down, God enables us to do that. God gives us the grace, and how it meets us is in a pool like that. You willingly submit all of that to God. Father, I'm putting it on that tree. God, I'm dying to this wrong desire. It's submerged. And in that, the Bible says, we identify with Christ. But you see, the beauty of that is this, then. We might, too, walk in the newness of life. You want that blank sheet? You want that fresh start? Identify with that pool. Identify with that death. Now, here's the key where it comes as a church and as a body. Men, I told you before, it excites me to see you walk in this. But it's my job to identify you now, no longer with the old, but Chet, with the new. I'm not supposed to call you to account for what happened yesterday. Why? Because you're new. Nick, I'm not supposed to say, well, yeah, but this and this and... No. That's dead. And you see, this is my challenge for us as a body. If we could begin to see each other based on that transformation, that James Helfer is new. He's changed. And because of that, he's my brother. And even though we may come against each other at some point, he's my family. And I love him. And I'm for him. And I don't want to identify him with yesterday, but today. And you see, we need God all the more to give us that vision for one another. Why? Because we live so close together, we can see each other's flaws. We can see each other's failings. We get to see each other grow up in the house of God. Sometimes that's a messy process. How much better, how much simpler, how much more wonderful would it be if in that I believe the best about Jake Evans, and I walked that out, you know what? Hey, I saw God touch you. I saw God do that. You remember when you went under the water? Yeah. Don't give that old man anything. He's dead. I'm believing you're a new man. I'm believing you're a new woman. And you see, we as a body put to death the old. And we can help one another walk that out. We all make mistakes. We're all going to fail. But don't identify me as who I used to be. Come on, somebody tell me who I am. And when we start doing that with each other, no. Barry, you're different. Dan, you're different. Lori, you're changed. Then you start saying, you know, that's true. And if they see, you see, it's easy to get off in our head and believe the lie and doubt the identity and start walking in it. And God's saying, I've changed you. Supernaturally on the inside, you're telling everybody about it on the outside. Now go let them know. And you see, I want to end with this. Matthew chapter 28, verse 19 says this, go therefore, the Great Commission, go therefore and make disciples of all nations. Now come on, hear this. Baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let me reword that just for a moment. Baptizing them, how about this? Identifying them. Putting to death the old and raising them to life in their true identity, knowing they're a product of what? The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. My Bible says in Genesis that God said, us make man in our image. What we see is this, a proclamation tonight of people saying, I'm going to identify with the one that made me. I'm going back to how God set it up, and I need your help. That's why I'm doing it openly, publicly. I'm letting you know I'm a part of something bigger. Let's walk this out together. Let's fight this battle one another, that we can guard our brothers, our sisters. Because there is an enemy, and he's real. But listen to me. He's been whooped. He's been put away. And for those that identify with Christ, the victory's ours. There's just some days I need to be reminded of that. There's just some days you need to be told you're not that old person. He's dead. She's dead. They're gone. And that's right. That's good. That's healthy. Listen to me. That's being the church. The church, listen to me. Don't be afraid to get excited about tonight. It's okay to hoop and holler and cheer. It's okay to shake the foundations of hell tonight. Because listen to me as I say this, and then I'll close. These ones have been snatched. They were on their way, like you and me, to a devil's hell. And God said, no. I've got another plan. That's something to rejoice about. That's something to get excited about. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank you, Lord, for your overwhelming power. God, you say that you are able to save to the uttermost, and you stand on it. God, you prove it. Lord, now it's our turn to make it known to the world you've done a work. You've changed us. You've renewed our mind. You've pulled us out of that broken, miry clay we thought we used to be. You've changed us. And Father, tonight, I pray that you'd set our mind to a place where we can think on higher things. We can live at a greater level, God, not on this earth, not focused on what we may see, but rather what you've done. And God, that in that heavenly mindset, we'd speak it out. We'd speak out what you've done, rather than being so focused on who we are, who we used to be. Father, come tonight and have your way in this service. Come and be glorified, Lord. Come and, Lord, I pray you would, with the indwelling of your Spirit, be in our midst tonight. In Jesus' wonderful, precious name we pray. Amen.
Tonight, we're going to switch things up just a little bit than what we've done in the past. Really believe that in everything that we do, particularly in this is a very, as has already been said, this is a very, very significant night. It's a very significant thing that we're going to do. And so what's going to happen is after we actually baptize each individual, when they come out of the water, there's several men here that are going to lay hands on them, and we as a church are going to knit our hearts together in prayer and pray for each one of them. Let it really be a seal, a new beginning, a day in which yesterday, even though I may have professed Jesus, I may have made the real statement of faith some time ago, even in several weeks or months ago, but tonight, in a very real statement, I'm going to say, no, yesterday's gone. Yesterday is thrown in the sea of forgiveness, and I am a new creation in Christ. And I'm declaring that boldly. And we're going to lay hands and pray that boldly so that it's sealed, so it's done. Never to go back around the mountain again, but to move forward.
Yes. Brittany Shea Caden Aldridge.
Jesus with all your heart? Do you trust in Him for the forgiveness of your sins and as Lord of your life? According to your profession of faith, is Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to His commands, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. With all your heart? Do you trust Him for the forgiveness of your sins and as Lord of your life? By your profession of faith, is Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to His command, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. With all your heart? Do you believe and trust in your heart that He has forgiven your sin and He's Lord of your life? By your profession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to His command, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Come on, let's just gather around them. God, right here over this family. God, over Brittany, over the children. God, we just ask that right now you would seal this work done by the power of your Holy Spirit. God, touch each one of them. God, we ask that you would pour out favor and mercy upon them. God, as they live a life that you've called them to live. Now, God, right here, by the power of your Spirit, by the grace of your Spirit, God, we say, have your way. Lord, make this proclamation visible to all who see them, to all who come across them. And God, fill them with your Spirit now in the name of Jesus. Have your way in these lives and be glorified by them in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
S.J. Esther Whitehead.
As Esther's coming up, I just want to make this statement. You know, each one of these individuals, as individuals or in a group, I've talked to in the last couple weeks. So I stand here as the pastor of this church, believing with all my heart, their profession. I'm not the one that saves. Their profession isn't the one that saves. Jesus is the one that saves. But there is something significant about making a statement of faith. And they've made it in their mouths, and now they're making it by their actions. You love Jesus with all your heart? You trust in Him for the forgiveness of your sins and as Lord of your life? Esther, by your profession of faith as Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and according to His commands, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Jesus, you said in your word to let the little children come to you, for of such belongs the kingdom of heaven. And Lord, we thank you that the heavens are open now, and that your kingdom truly has come to earth, especially in the heart of this child. And Father, we pray now that she would be sealed by the power of your Holy Spirit, that he would be her portion all the days of her life, Lord. We pray that you would lead and guide her in your word and in your ways. Father, that wisdom from on high would be released in her life, God, and that even through this profession and this transformation of your Holy Spirit, God, that you would make an eternal difference in her life all the days of her life, Father. We bless you. We glorify you, Lord, for great salvation in the earth in her life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Luke Robbins.
Luke, do you love Jesus with all your heart?
Yes.
Do you trust in Him as your Lord and Savior and for the forgiveness of your sins? By your profession of faith, as Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to His commands, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Aiden Robbins.
Jesus, you trust in Him for the forgiveness of your sins and as Lord of your life? By your profession of faith as Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to His commands, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Jesus, for these two young men. These arrows being raised up in your house, O God. Now seal this moment in their hearts, O God, for all eternity. Now, Holy Spirit, come. Have your way, O God. Let this be known as the moment that they became the sons of thunder. Open scripture up to them, God. Open their understanding, O God, to hear your voice in the nighttime, calling their names. Thank you, Jesus. In your name, amen.
Amen.
Tyra Sheldon.
Hi.
Jesus with all your heart? Do you trust in him for the forgiveness of your sins and as Lord of your life? By your profession of faith as Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to his command, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Father God, we thank you, God, for trusting us with this soul. Oh, Father, this day may it be memorable in this woman's life, oh, God. Father, that your spirit testifies to her spirit that she is your child, oh, God. That she's come to be part of your family, oh, Lord. And that nothing can snatch her out of your hand. Father God, I pray that righteousness will prevail in her life. That your spirit will guide and open the way of her understanding, O Lord, that she may come to know you in a deeper way. May her testimony, O Lord, amaze and astonish. May she be a testimony of your mercy and grace to her family and to anyone that comes in contact with her. In the name of Jesus, we love you and we praise you. Amen.
Amen.
Cameron Butler. Cameron.
Cameron, do you love Jesus with all your heart? Do you trust in him for the forgiveness of your sins and as Lord of your life? By your profession of faith as Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to his command, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah. Father God, in the name that's above every name, the name of Jesus, we thank you that you have released him from the burdens of sin. And now he's proclaiming to the world, Lord God, that you're Lord of his life, that you're going to live, that he's going to live for you every single day of his life, that no longer will he ever walk in bondage again, but God, he'll walk in newness of life every single day, that you've called him and set him apart for your glory. And so we give you praise. We give you thanks. We give you honor for this in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
Michael Cook. Michael?
Michael, do you love Jesus with all your heart?
Yes, sir.
Do you trust in him for the forgiveness of your sins and as Lord of your life?
Yes, sir.
By your profession of faith, as Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to his commands, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Congratulations. Father, we thank you so much, Lord, for your perfect time. God, you don't ever forget. You know the plans you have for your people, and God, you bring them to pass. And Lord, I thank you that at the right time, Father, you snatched our brother out from the grips of hell to redeem him, to change him. Now, Father, tonight in front of this church and all of history, God, seal your work. Seal your work, Father, to the depth of who he is, that he would no longer identify as the man that he was, but God, as who you've called him to be. God, let your word bring forth life within him and let it grow until the time he sees you face to face. Father, as you've had your way before in his life, have your way once again tonight. Be glorified, God. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Chet Flory.
You've known Chet for a long time. Been around the mountain a few times. We're going to pray tonight. And according to his profession of faith, but more importantly, according to the grace of God. Yes. This is the last time around the mountain. Chet, do you love Jesus with all your heart? Do you trust in him for the forgiveness of your sin?
I do.
Do you trust him as Lord of your life?
I do.
By your profession of faith, as Jesus Christ, as your Lord and Savior, and according to his commands, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Jesus, we're asking that from days gone by. God, as this man has gone down and comes back up, Lord, I'm asking that you would raise him to new life in this moment. God, the places of old are buried and stuck in the ground. God, we're asking that you would bring life to this man in this moment. God, as his profession has come forth tonight, God, I'm asking that old things would pass away. And God, that all things would become new in this moment. Lord, I'm asking that your spirit would begin to speak to him in the night hour. God, that you would visit him during the day on the job. But God, most importantly, that your spirit would come and fill him in a way that strength rises up on the inside. And God, that the latter days of serving you would be more strong, that they would be more filled than the former days. And God, that he would not look back but run forward in your spirit. God, that his profession today would be the marker of a life. And a testimony to those who say, I can't do it. But God, that your spirit would be on the words he speaks from this day forward. God, raise him up with the character and the strength and the wisdom of a man who can lead others to you. God, bring it forward in this day. Holy Spirit, fill him in this moment. Empower him, grace him, and bless him by the power of your spirit. In Jesus' name, amen.
Nick Bristol.
Trust in him for the forgiveness of your sins and as Lord of your life. By your profession of faith as Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to his command, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Father, we thank you today, Lord, that truly old things have passed away and all things have become new. Father, we thank you that broken off of his life are the old habits, the old ideas, the old ways of thinking, God, and that now that you've implanted inside of him a new heart. Father, we thank you, Lord, that that new heart would be filled with your spirit, filled with your power, filled with a fresh hunger and a greater desire, Lord, to pursue you than he's ever pursued anything in this world. Father, we ask now that you would come as only you can and give him an insatiable desire, Lord, to know you more. Jesus, we ask for greater revelations of who you are, God, greater desire to love you and to know you. Jesus, we thank you that this son has come to glory, Lord.
Yes, God.
be honored and glorified from this day forward in his life. In Jesus' name, God, we thank you that every assignment of the enemy is canceled off of his life, and that there's a new lease, God, that there's a new purpose and greater destiny for him. In Jesus' name, amen.
Alan Keyholz. Alan.
Profession of faith as Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to his command, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Father, your word says that our sins are far, far, as far as the east is from the west. You've put this man's sins away, oh God. And we trust and we believe, oh Lord, that before this cloud of witnesses, God, that this man is saying, I love you and I want to follow you and I want to pursue you and pursue you hard. Father, we pray, oh God, you give him what it takes, the grace that helps him walk in a manner worthy of being called your son. Father, I pray that as he says, I'm dead to sin, I'm dead to my old way of life, I identify with Christ, that this man walks in power, Lord, in power every day of his life. Father, that everything that has been lost be redeemed in you, O God. There is no loss, but only that of sin. Everything else is gained for this man from this day on. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Brandon Lundmark.
Brandon, you love Jesus with all your heart. Trust in him for the forgiveness of your sins and as Lord of your life. By your profession of faith as Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to his command, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
I thank you that no longer is this man identified by the things of the past, but now he's identified by a brand new name. That, Lord God, he holds a crown in heaven, Lord God, that'll never fade away, that'll never pass, Lord God, but he'll walk every single day in newness of life, that his mind will be renewed, that his life will be an example of what the Lord Jesus Christ died on the cross for, what he rose again from the grave for, that, Lord God, he would walk new all the way through the rest of his days. That, Lord God, he be a shining example of your glory on this earth, Lord God. I speak over his life that he be glory to you in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Warren Merriweather.
Thank you.
love Jesus with all your heart? Do you trust in him for the forgiveness of your sins and as Lord of your life? Warned by your profession of faith as Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to his commands, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Jesus, for new life.
Yes, Lord.
That we were buried with you, yes, but we are raised in new life.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for putting a new song in Warren's mouth.
Yes, Lord.
And that he will sing your praises,
yes, Lord.
And it will be in his mouth for the rest of his days. Thank you for new life, God.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for the latter days being better than the former days.
Yes,
and that by this testimony, he will be a deliverer in your name, Jesus.
Yes.
That he will walk with you.
Yes.
Let your praises spring from his mouth.
Yes, God.
From this day forth, God, yes, and forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
Jonathan Murray.
Trust in him for the forgiveness of your sins and as Lord of your life. John, by your profession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to his command, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Father, we thank you so much.
Yes,
God, not just for a profession of faith, but God, the fruits of it.
Yes.
And Lord, I pray not just for 30 nor 60, God, I pray in his life,
yes, Lord.
God, for that hundredfold.
Yes.
Lord, that you would produce through him and from him, God, more and more and more for your glory. God, for your kingdom. God, you didn't waste time when he got here getting a hold of him. And Lord, I pray that you grow him up in knowledge, God, that he'd grow in wisdom, Lord, that he would find you in your word and be changed. And God, that as he walks and grows with you, you'd put to death more and more the old. And God, allow him to walk in the new. And Lord, I pray that everywhere he goes, God, there'd be an overflow of you. God, that you'd flow from him. God, you'd come from his heart, from his mind, from his lips. God, that everything that he does, you would be the product of. God, you would get the glory from. And Lord, I pray you'd seal him.
Yes.
Seal him tonight, Father, for you and your work only, God. For you and your will only. Seal him, God, and have your way in his life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Jimmy Pike.
Trust him as Lord of your life. You believe he's forgiven your sins. By your profession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to his command, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
J.
Jesus, with the same shout that he just let out, God, I'm asking that over the whole world, God, everywhere he goes, every place he sets his foot, God, that the shout of the King would come from his lungs, oh God. Lord, that your spirit would be on the inside of him. And God, everywhere he goes, that he would proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ. God, I'm asking that you would turn Jimmy's life upside down in this day, God, in this hour, and that you would cause him to let everyone know what you've done in his life. God, even from the little boy age, God, you've been calling him. And God, today is the completion of that. And God, we're asking that you would take those prayers from his grandma and his mom. And God, that you would cause them to grow in this day. God, that you would cause them to come to completion in this day. And God, that your spirit would fill him with power, with glory, and with might.
Yes, God.
Lord, seal it in his life. Seal it in his heart. And God, cause him to walk his life out as a man of character, a man of no reproach. God, a man who follows you and longs for you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Adam Stoops.
Adam, you love Jesus with all your heart. You trust tonight. Really trust inside of your heart that he really is Lord. He's forgiven you of your sin. By your profession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to his command, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Father, we thank you tonight, Lord, for the new thing that you're doing in the earth.
Yes, God.
Father, we thank you for the power of your Holy Spirit that has come and snatched as a brand from the fire this man's life. Father, we thank you now that his life is in your hands.
Yes.
And that all the days of his life, God, that you would continue to lead him and guide him. Father, we thank you that the heavens are open and that your voice would echo tonight, God, that he would hear you say, you are a beloved son. You're not a bastard child. You're not an outcast, but you are a beloved son. Father, we thank you that this is a son that you have purpose and destiny for. Father, we thank you that he is a son of promise, God, and that every promise over his life would be fulfilled because of your power, because of your grace, and because of your spirit. Father, we declare that all the things from the past, God, that have held him back, that they are broken in the name of Jesus. Every chain is broken, Father.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus, Lord. That there's grace and growth ahead.
Yes,
we bless you and we declare it. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Jimmy Woods.
Forgiven your sin and is Lord of your life.
Yes, sir.
Okay, grab hold of my arm. Jimmy, by your profession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to his command, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Father, Jimmy is in your hands, and we trust you with him. Father, we believe that his soul is being moved and changed, that your spirit is being changed in him, oh God. We pray you continue to do a work in him, oh Lord. Make the character of Christ be built in this man's heart, oh God. May integrity, truthfulness, loyalty, oh Lord, be pervasive all over his life, oh God. The old is passed away, the new has come. And we celebrate, Lord. For Jimmy has come to your family and he's saying, I want to be your son, oh God. Father, I pray you keep him, walk with him, be with him, oh Lord, every day of his life, in the name of Jesus. Amen.
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 Jonathan Ziegler.
Jonathan, do you love Jesus with all your heart?
Yes, I do.
Do you trust in him for the forgiveness of your sins?
Yes, I do.
Do you truly believe that he's your Lord?
Yes, I do.
By your profession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and according to his command, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Father, for Jonathan.
Yes,
God.
Yes.
Thank you for calling him unto yourself and making him your own. Thank you for making him your own son.
Yes, Lord.
For making him a new creation. Now, God, seal it. Make this undeniable. Rewire the thoughts. We curse the evil one against his life in this moment. We know, Holy Spirit, that you have done this.
Yes, God.
And that you have called him your beloved.
Yes, Lord.
Now shape the character, God. In the days ahead, as he wakes up every morning, help him see your face. Help him hear your voice.
Yes, God.
And those around him, help him see you, Jesus. Thank you for Jonathan.
Yes.
In your name, Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Let's give God an incredible round of applause. Praise your name, Lord God. Praise your holy name. We praise you, O God. We exalt you, Lord. We lift your name on high. We thank you tonight, God, for who you are, all that you are, and all that you've done. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Praise your name. Praise your holy name. Praise your holy name. Thank you, Lord. In the scriptures, at Jesus' Last Supper, it said they sang a hymn and went out. Well, the thing that's closest to the Lord's Supper in significance is baptism. And I think it'd be right to sing a hymn before we go out.
Yes.
And in the midst of that, truly, truly, there's no better testimony than what happens when one soul goes under the water and comes back up. The newness of life comes by the grace of God. The newness of life is stepped into by faith. But it's a powerful testimony that God can take what's old and make it new. God can take what's rotten and make it good. God can take what's lost and find it in such a way that it can never be lost again. And tonight, if you're here in this room and you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, what better night to step forward in faith and trust in him? And as we sing this last song, Tom's going to be up front. And if you believe and trust tonight, like you maybe never have before, that Jesus is your Lord and Savior, come on up and let Tom pray for you. The guys pray for you. But let's sing this hymn from our heart. It's a new song about how we are risen in God. It's a great testimony to what's gone on tonight, to the power of God that's moving in here in our midst. And let it be that tonight just happens again in a few more months, or hey, maybe in a few more weeks. I'll take 20 in a couple weeks. That'd be great. How about that? If not, we're going to come back around. We're going to come back around, and we're going to come back around.
to the wonderful opportunity to declare out loud through the public statement of baptism and through the declaration of our voice that Jesus Christ really is Lord and He really is the forgiver of our sins and we really can love Him and awesomely get to love Him with all our hearts. Christy.
We were the fallen, the runaway kind, lost in the shadows, desperate for life. You came with mercy, not the faraway kind, and called us from
resurrection.
Church, this is a celebration. I thank God for what He's doing in our midst. We have such a privilege, and I pray we would never forget that. Let's pray. Let's thank Him for what He's done and what He's doing. God, we thank You so much, Lord, for Your undeserved mercy. God, many times we don't even look for it, and yet You long to give it to us. God, I thank You tonight for the three that came and professed faith in Your name. Now seal them, save them, do Your work in their life, God. And Lord, seal all those that in a public profession they claimed Your name above every other name. God, send us away tonight rejoicing, singing, praising, testifying of Your goodness, of Your faithfulness. And Lord, let it grow in us until we meet again. God, I thank You so much to be a part of the best thing going. God, open our eyes all the more. Father, I pray tonight, like Moses asked to see Your glory, Father, I pray You'd peel that veil back just a little more, that we can look into heaven. God, that we can have a birth of something new on the inside of us that would carry us through, that would give us a desire and a passion to live all the more for You, willing to let go of this world. God, You come and be most glorified tonight. For we ask it, we believe it, God. In Jesus' name we pray. And all God's people said, amen. God bless you.